against a Taven. Now, to begin with, I always have started by sharing the trip where I first began, which involved a piece of rope and some scissors. And of course, an assistant. So, if you'd like to welcome Sam onto stage. To begin with, I'd just like you to examine the rope. Make sure that's an ordinary rope.
Yeah, it is,
yeah. It's not some weird rope.
Don't think so.
And examine the scissors as well. Make sure they're ordinary scissors. Careful, don't pick up.
Yeah, they're scissors.
Thanks. Now, when I get to the middle of the rope like this, I'll have my feet down. You just say stop for me. If you can do that, that would be great.
Stop.
Right here?
Yeah.
Okay, if you just cut the rope here. You can put the scissors down. Now we've got two pieces of rope, but they're not quite the same length. So in that case, we're going to have to start again. Oh. Now, I was going to tell you all a rope. I was going to tell you all a rope joke tonight, but it's too long. Yeah, so I'm just going to tie the ends together. Might have to get it back later if there's no end to the rope, there'll be no end to the trick. Now, this time I'm going to take a step further. Could you please hold the things like this, and if you're playing rock, paper, scissors, and just cut here for me? Okay. Just careful when you put those pieces together. Let's try the ends now. So we're back to where we started, but two pieces of rope are not the same length. But this time we'll just use magic to get the same length. Restore the rope completely. There you go, we have the rope completely restored. Yeah, I know where a lot of you are probably looking at the knot. But in that case, we can just use magic. When is it not a knot? When it's not. For my next effect, I've brought along some cards, all of which have a different symbol written on. We've got a plus sign, we've got a star, we've got a circle, you've got some wavy lines and a square. If I can start by giving these to you and ask you to just mix them up for me, that would be great. And while you do that, I'm just going to introduce this, which is chart numbers 1 to 5. And on this side, we've got all the different symbols. So now that you've mixed them up, could you please pass me anyone, but don't look at it. Just pass me anyone, yeah. Just spread them, give me everyone. Just spread them, hand me anyone. This one here?
Yeah.
Now to begin with, I'm going to let you decide where would you like me to place this symbol? 1, 2, 3, 4, or 5?
I would like that in 4.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay, would you like to pass me another one? Once again, don't look at it. Now this time I'm going to get someone from the audience to help. And now I'm you at the front. And can you please tell me where would you like me to place this symbol? 1, 2, 3, or 5?
3.
Okay, would you pass me another one? Thank you. Now I'll let you do so over there. What's your name? Alan, good to meet you, Alan. Would you please tell me where would you like me to place this symbol? 1, 2, or 5?
5.
Finally, yeah. One more. Now this time, let's use you over there. Can I say your name?
Sarah.
Sarah, we've got 1 and 2 left.
One.
Okay, now we've got just one symbol left. And to make this first possible, I'm going to get you decide this time. If you'd like me to place this symbol with the last number left, 2, or swap it with any other one.
Swap. We're going to swap. We're going to do that one in 5.
This one in 5, okay, so we'll just swap places then with these two.
Yeah.
Here we go. Now, would all of you admit you had a complete free choice? You could place the symbols anywhere you liked.
Yeah.
And I gave them to you and you shuffled them, correct?
Yeah.
But I haven't told you yet that I did hypnotise all of you before I came on tonight, so you would know which numbers to put which symbol with. And obviously, as mentioned, these symbols were in view the whole time, and they were the matching symbols, but the game was you had to match the correct symbols with its mate. And I hypnotised all of you to do that, because all of you were correct. Now for my last and final effect of the evening, I'm going to bring back a story about before I got into magic. Who here is interested in football? Okay, yeah, quite a few of you. Before I got into magic, football was my interest, and I used to dream of being a footballer. And I played in goal, and my hero was Peter Schmeichel, who was an ex-legendary goalkeeper for Manchester United. And of course, along his autobiography with me tonight, I was feeling nostalgic, and I thought, why not do an effect using his autobiography and the power of the human mind. So we'll need a volunteer, so could I have someone from the audience come help me? Thanks, give her a round of applause. Now, this book is an ordinary book. What I'm going to do is give the book to you. If you could please open the book to any page. Just open the book to any page, tell me when you're done.
Yep.
Okay, now, are all the words on that page different?
Probably.
Okay, please remember any word on that page. Just remember any word. You got a word in mind?
Yep.
Okay, close the book. Now, so you don't forget it, as you can see on the back of the book, there's a post-it note. Could you please write a word on that post-it note for me? Tell me when you're done. Tear the post note off. Tear the post note off and hand me the book. Thank you. Now, if I had to make a guess, I'd say there's at least 100,000 words in this book, which makes a 1 in 100,000 chance I can know which word Katie has thought of. But I'm here to demonstrate that if you use your mind, anything is possible. So really, I'm going to come around to your level here. I'm just going to open the book to any page. Is your word on this page? Is your word the first word on this page by any chance?
No.
Is it not? Would have been impressive though. In that case, I'm going to use my mind. So I've brought along my pad with me, as everyone can see. I'm going to ask you to think of your word. Imagine shouting out loud in your head so that everyone can hear you, but only in your head. And I'm going to read your mind. Okay, so look at me and think of your word. Okay, do you mind holding out your finger like that? Look at me. Okay, you have to see. I've got something. It's got a few vowels in it. Look at me. Okay. Something which you'd say to someone when in a sports match or something of something. Don't know whether that rings a bell, but I'll only find out in the end. Me? I think it's a good secret, can it? Okay. I think I've got it. Would you please tell me and the audience now for the first time which word are you thinking of?
Overview.
Overview, yes.